definitely look like that. You've got a handbelt driven engine, like you've got a Peugeot or a Renault or something like that engine, and you've crafted that together very well. You've spent some hours making that. You've got a mass-produced traction, essentially the only one in the world. It must take you a couple of thousand hours to get it all put together. 2 years in the manufacturing. Come on. Next we've got a Series 3 Field Marshal made in Gainsbury, Lincolnshire. It's got a 4.8 litre single cylinder two-stroke diesel engine. I drove this last year, I remember driving this. I'm a case man myself, with all my clutch levers and stuff like that, it's with your hands. This has only got a clutch pedal on the right hand side, and nearly 5 litres. I stalled it about 10 foot in there. I weren't used to the pedal, but it's a single cylinder. Came out about 1949. They changed the engine direction on the Marshalls to go the other direction to try and stop the
panel.
Oh, hang on. It's not a bad design. No, it's from Ashby. Yeah. So it's a local tractor all the time. Back to Little Great Virgin. They made 517,651 of these. The first date was the 6th of July 1946, and the last date was October 56. I think it was the 20th, if I remember right. I can't remember right. They've got the same engine as the standard Vanguard car. Petrol paraffin, started to put petrol and turn it over. 4-speed gearbox, little 12-volt version.